We did this analysis because we wanted to understand patients' experience after their healthcare provider had prescribed a PCSK9 inhibitor for them. We wanted to understand whether they were filling the prescription and whether their insurance was covering it. And the reason that we did this is because it was a follow-up to a data analysis and a publication that we had done a couple of years ago. And at that time, we showed that the access to PCSK9 was very poor. So we wanted to see if it had improved. And we looked at it in two different ways. We looked at it over time, and we looked at it compared to other cardiovascular medications. And between these two time periods, a number of important events had occurred. First of all, there were two large cardiovascular outcome studies that showed that the use of PCSK9 inhibitors reduced cardiovascular events. This led to an expansion of the label or the use of the PCSK9 inhibitors. These drugs were included in clinical guidelines. And then finally, the cost of PCSK9 inhibitors was reduced by about 60%. So what we found when we compared these two time periods was that the percent of prescriptions that were rejected during the first time period was 46%. And during the second time period, it went down to 31%. So really what we saw is that access went from very poor to a little bit better, but still too low. And then the second way that we looked at access was we compared it to other similar cardiometabolic drugs. And what we saw was that the rejection rate, the number of prescriptions that were not covered by insurance with the other cardiometabolic drugs was between 4 and 15%. And again, that compared to 31% for the PCSK9 inhibitors.